Alright, so before I get into the trick, I want to give a quick shout out to Card Shuffler 99. Make sure to click on the link and check them out. You guys will not be disappointed in their videos. Anyways, guys, here's the actual video. Alright, so to start off the trick, the spectator can shuffle up the deck, and they can even pick their own cards. So let's say they pick one from the middle. Now, in this case, I don't really want to look at it, so let's go ahead. I'll show you guys your card, so make sure you guys can remember it. And let's say we get it lost into the middle of the deck. As you guys can see, I have no breaks. I'll cut up the deck a little bit, get the cards mixed up, and then from here, let's say I'm gonna go through them and I'm gonna go ahead and look through the deck looking for your cards. So in this case, let's say I take your card, which should be the Queen of Spades. I'm going to make it invisible and I'm gonna let you hold on to it. Now I want you to pick a number, let's say 1 through 52. And let's say you wanted to pick a number like 13, so we'll count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Now in the 13th position, this should not be your card, because obviously your card is still invisible. So go ahead and place your invisible card back on here, and let's go ahead and redo the count. So now your card should be, I snap my fingers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. In the 13th position, we should have your card, the Queen of Spades. So this is a trick, guys, and if you want to do it, don't forget to stick around for the tutorial. Alright, so the good thing about this trick is that you can use any deck of cards, and it can be borrowed, and you can have the spectator mix it up as well. So, to start it off, let's say the spectator could go through, and they could really pick any card that they want to. And now, what you're doing as they pick that card is you're just looking at the bottom card, in this case, the King of Hearts, and you're getting yourself a key card. So go ahead, remember the bottom card, and the spectator looks at theirs. In this case, they have the Eight of Spades. So you don't know what their card is yet, but what you do is you tell them you're going to mix it up. So you leave their eight or whatever their card is on top and say, let's go ahead and lose it in the middle. So you cut the deck, leaving their key card directly above their card. And you can say, go ahead, mix up the deck a little bit, cut it up, and you only let them cut the deck in half. This way the card won't get separated with the key card. So then you take the deck yourself, you look at it, the spectator is not going to be seeing it. And you're going through looking for that key card, the King of Hearts. So you go through, you find the king. Now what you want to do here is cut the deck so that your key card ends up at the bottom. So you cut the deck, your key card goes to the bottom. You know their card is the Eight of Spades. You flip the deck back over, and now you kind of put it down. The spectator has not seen anything. So at this point, their card is going to be on top, and you say, you know what? Let's go ahead, let's make your card the Eight of Spades invisible. And at this point, the spectator is going to be kind of amazed because you already do know their card. And you say it's going to be invisible, and you say, go and hold on to it for me. And then at this point, you say, I want you to pick a number 1 through 52. Now, as you say that, you say, look, I want you to pick a number 1 through 52. You kind of just misdirect the spectator's counting off 3 cards just like this. So their card's going to be on top. You count out 3 cards, put it back into a pinky break, and at this point the spectator should have picked a number. And if you want to, you can tell them to pick one that is 1 through 26, just so you don't have to count out so many cards. Or you can give them an option like 5 through 26, because you don't really want them picking any number like 2 or 3 or 1. So let's say they were to pick 7. So what you do is you actually deal off the top card. So you have a 3 card break, you actually deal off the top card. This is a single card, and this is theirs. You place that to the bottom, you say that's 1 card, and then you go to the break, grabbing 2 cards, and you say 2. So you count this 2 card packet as 1, so you say 1, 2, and you just drop it on top, so this way the cards don't really separate. You have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and you stop to one number below the card, that or the number they pick. So in this case they pick 7, so you say, look, now this is the 7th card, or this is the card in the 7th position, and as you can see, it's not yours because obviously yours is invisible. So go ahead, place your invisible card on the deck. They can place their invisible card back in here. You pick up the cards from the table, put it back on top, and you say, okay, let's try this again. So then from here, you can really count 7 cards, or you can have the spectators do it, and it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and in the 7th position, it should be their card. So this is a trick, guys. I hope you guys like it, and as always, thanks for watching.